Hi everyone. So, here we are with a look at Apple's big announcement. They announced Metal at their WWDC conference. Now, what this basically is a way for games developers to reach the lower level of hardware without as much OpenGL sitting in the way. Now, the reason this is kind of important is because Apple has kind of stolen a march on Google here in the Android operating system. Apple have taken technology concepts which we're becoming very familiar with in the traditional gaming space, with, for instance, AMD's Mantle technology, and Microsoft's push to DirectX 12, which will also provide what we call bare metal access to the GPU technology. That's the bit that basically makes graphics work on a mobile device, games console, or a PC. Now, the reason Apple are doing this is quite simple. OpenGL is a bit of a bloated mess. It's been known as a bloated mess for a very, very long time. DirectX is also a bloated mess. Now, the idea here really is to get away from having an abstraction layer, a big, thick, chunky abstraction layer getting in the way. That basically means that every time a developer wants to do something on the GPU, it first has to go through decades worth of cruft to get its instruction to the GPU, get a response back, and do the processing on screen. Now, with Metal, games developers are able to basically send their information directly to the GPU, program directly on the GPU, and have that information returned to the screen. And that is allowing for some truly stunning results. I am not joking when I say this is a watershed moment in mobile gaming. Now, the reason we're talking about this here is because, well, how will Google respond? More importantly, can Google respond with a fragmented ecosystem the way they do? The reason the likes of AMD, Microsoft, and Apple are able to go for this bare metal access is because they control their ecosystems to a certain extent. AMD, for instance, makes the Radeon style of graphics cards, popularized by ATI before they bought them. They control the hardware, they control the drivers, and they control, to a certain extent, the OpenGL and DirectX that is operated on those cards. By providing a third path, a path that doesn't have either OpenGL or Direct3D available, but gives direct bare metal access, AMD can effectively tell developers, hey, if you do it like this, you will get this, a massive performance boost. We've seen it in Battlefield 4 and other games. It's worth a minimum of 30% in some cases, a 30% performance boost over other techniques. That's a watershed moment, guys. Now, here's our problem. Where everybody else is able to control the chip designs, the software layer, and to a certain extent, the way games developers are going to access those resources, for Google, they're kind of in a bit of a strange space. Yes, they control the software implementation, but they have zero control over the hardware implementation. And that's where this kind of technique, this direct bare metal access technique, can really come into its own. Because we have the likes of Samsung, Qualcomm, and a multitude of other processor design companies building ARM chips, creating their designs based on ARM's reference, the same way that Apple does, we find ourselves in a strange situation where Google essentially has to get all of these hardware manufacturers to agree to a single principle, a single way to access those reference designs within hardware. I can't see that is going to happen anytime soon, in my opinion, mostly because of the fragmented nature of Android, but also because, well, can you imagine trying to get four or five chip companies to all agree on a single way to handle GPU? It isn't going to happen. There's too much infighting within the Android ecosystem to ever see that happen. What I think we'll find is Google will partner up with the likes of Samsung, the likes of Qualcomm, to produce a single reference design for GPU. Probably based on Crate, or its next cousin, as it were. Now, if Google isn't able to make that happen, what I'm afraid we're going to see is really a two-tier gaming within the mobile space. You will have what Apple can do and what Google can do. And Google, I'm afraid, the Android ecosystem would be potentially 30 to 40% behind what Apple can do. Now, we're not talking about raw frame rates here. What we're really talking about is graphical fidelity. The number of polygons you can push around a screen, the texture quality, the level of textures, things like depth of field, bloom, and everything like that. Essentially, Apple is able to get very close to recreating console gaming graphics on their mobile parts. Google, on the other hand, may find itself, unfortunately, playing second fiddle for a fair while to come. We're going to have to wait and see what happens at Google I.O. 2014. I do expect there to be some movement on graphics aspect, but I don't believe we'll see Google move to a bare metal process.